Students, in this video we are going to discuss about operation perform on dependent variable. So in the last classes we have discussed about the operation performed on independent variable. So you know that independent variable is time, and the operation performed on independent variable are time scaling, time shifting and time reversal. Now we are going to see the operation performed on dependent variable. Here the dependent variable is an amplitude, okay? So various operation performed on dependent variable are amplitude scaling. We can add two signals and we can multiply signals, then you perform differentiation on the signal, then you can perform the integration on the signal. Okay, first we will discuss about amplitude scaling. Considered a signal x of t, okay? So it's somewhat considered any signal in x of t. Now I am going to perform amplitude scaling for this signal. What is the meaning is, the amplitude of the signal x of t is going to scale by a factor a. This may be a whole number or a rational number, okay? Now here, if here this is a continuous time signal, here I have performed amplitude scaling for the continuous time signal, okay? Now y of t is obtained by multiplying the corresponding value of x of t by a scalar value a. Okay, for example, you have studied about amplifier, right? So what the amplifier will do, if your input is 2 volt, right? So if you fed into an amplifier, consider this is a system amplifier. So what it will do, depending upon the gain what we have designed, suppose I have designed for a gain of 4, okay, this amplifier will produce an output whose amplitude is 8, right? Okay, so here what it does, it scales the amplitude by a factor of 4. So this is what the one of the real time example for an amplitude scaling. Okay, similarly, if you want to perform discrete time signals, the same thing here, you are going to consider x of n, we are going to multiply it by a constant a. So here, which is nothing but y of n, okay? So both, for both continuous time signal and discrete time signal, the amplitude scaling is applicable, okay? Now we will see some examples in this. So here, for example, considered a continuous time signal, here it is a sawtooth waveform which is having an amplitude of 2 and minus 2, okay? Now it is going to perform an amplitude scaling of by a factor of 6. So 6 into x of t. So here this 2 is multiplied by 6. So here the amplitude is scaled by a factor of 12. Okay, so this is what the amplitude scaling. It is very, very simple only. Okay, I think, hope you understand this concept, right? Now consider this discrete time signal x of n. Here it is having only 3 sequences, minus 1, 0 at 1. The minus 1 value is 1, 0 to 1, 3. So here I am going to perform this amplitude scaling by a factor of 1 by 2. Just multiplying the amplitude by 1 by 2. So 1 by 2, 2. 1 into 1 by 2, 1, 3 into 1 by 2, 3 by 2. So this is whatever example for amplitude scaling. It is very simple. Just we are going to scale the amplitude by a given factor. Now consider the second operation, addition, okay? So consider two signal x1 of t, x2 of t, y of t is equal to x1 of t plus x2 of t, okay? So here this is what your x1 of t and x2 of t. Now we need to add these two signal. I think already we have discussed about these additions of signals, okay? Now consider these two operation. This here it is minus 1 to 0, it is 2. So I have drawn 2 here, okay? Here it is 0, so this will proceed like this, okay? 0 to 1 here. So here 1 to 2, at 1 here it is 2, so here at 1 it is 3, so at 1 it is 1, so it is 3, okay? So from 1 again it is rising by 3, okay? Now consider this 2 here, 2 at 2 it is 2, at 2 it is 2, so it is 4. So this is a slope, so I have joined like this and I have added the two signals. Now consider the two discrete time sequence x1 of n, x2 of 2, and y is equal to addition of x1 of 2 plus x2 of 2. X1 of n is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, and x2 of n is 1, 1, 1. This is the value at the origin. Now I am going to add these two signal. Okay, so just I am adding the amplitudes, corresponding amplitude. So I have plotted these sequence. So this is what your y of n, right? So it is 2, 3, 4, 5. So it is very simple addition. Now consider the multiplication. Y of t is equal to x1 of t into x2 of t. This is the x1 of t signal, x2 of t signal. Already I have think we have discussed this example. Now x1 of t into x2 of t, just multiplying it, that is minus 1 into minus 2, it is 2. So it is I have plotted this as 2 here, 1 into 2, 2, so it is 2. In the range 1 to 2, it is 1. Here it is minus 1, so it is minus 1. Okay, so this is what you x1 of t into x2 of t, and similar operation you can do it for for discrete time sequence. Next one, x1 of n, x2 of n, just direct multiplication. So here 1, 8, 3, 8. So I have plotted 1, 8, 3, 8 here. So far we have discussed about these three operations. This differentiation and integration we will discuss after dealing with the basic signals and some important concepts in signals. Then only you will understand these differentiation and integration concepts. Thank you.